Burnsworth, a mystery illness has top medical experts focused on Santa Barbara tonight. This is a story News Channel 3 broke 3 weeks ago and involves a local teen. We knew her name at the time, but out of respect for the family and concern for her condition, we chose not to reveal it. Tonight, her family is ready to tell her story. It was during a day of celebration, a belated party for Grace Fisher's 17th birthday, when life took a horrific turn. In a matter of minutes, Grace was paralyzed and unable to breathe on her own. That was 1 month ago this week. Doctors at Cottage Hospital diagnosed the teen with acute flaccid myelitis, a polio-like syndrome impacting children nationwide. Grace is the 101st case.
You depend on that type of student to make your school culture really strong, and we miss her terribly here.
All of the groups that she's involved with kind of just show their love by like printing out pictures or cutting out hearts, which are glued in her hospital room on the wall, so when she's awake she can look up and see all the love that she has.
As you can see, there are a lot of hearts. After all, Grace is in at least a half dozen groups. She sings, dances, plays guitar, cello, piano, and gives music lessons to children. Laura and Haley Hunter each have a message for Grace.
If she tries hard enough, she can definitely get over it.
We really miss her and we'd like her to come back.
A nurse with the Craig Rehab Hospital in Denver, which specializes in neuro and spinal rehab, is now assessing Grace. Meanwhile, the community is rallying around her.
Gracie, we all love you, we all miss you, and we all know you can get through this. It's just a bump in the road.
And the community will host a trio of lunches this Sunday in an effort to help defray the Fishers' mounting medical costs. For more information and how to donate, you can log on to our website at KEYT.com.